This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, so log into master.
Yep.
Maximize the screen. Can you go to your Ansible directory? So etc Ansible is the directory. So always there only the best practice. You can create anywhere also playbooks. It's up to you. But generally we'll use this directory as a default directory for our to create our playbooks and all. Yeah, so open your playbook. So today I want to show some shortcuts in playbook.
Okay.
So do you have any playbook already? So can you open
yes.
that? Just cat.
Yeah.
Cat.
Okay. I forgot what was the name. Let me check.
Okay.
Test.yml.
Yeah. Yes.
Test.
So if it is a small file to open, just to open a file, cat is enough. Okay, generally I'm saying. Okay, guys, in this playbook, what we are doing? So we are creating a file first. We are creating a user, then installing a packages, right? This is what I am doing. Here, today I want to show some shortcuts in any playbook. I want to see how many tasks in I have in my playbook. Maybe here only 3 tasks you have, but in real time you would have even 100 tasks also in a single playbook. Okay, so again opening a playbook and checking all the task names, it's little difficult it may be. So without opening also you can check your task, how many tasks you have. The description you given, right? Only that description name you can see. Let's see that. Ansible hyphen playbook without space and your playbook name. Don't execute, just type it. Your playbook name space hyphen hyphen list hyphen tasks. Yeah, enter. It will show you only how many tasks available in this playbook. Okay, just shortcut kind of. Instead of opening your playbook, you can do this one. See, so tag concept, I will tell you what is tag. Tag something is there, right? At the end, I'll tell you what is tag. Before this list of tasks, I have to say one more thing, that is dry run. So guys, generally what does that mean, dry run, trial run? We can call it as anyway. So dry run means it will show exactly what will happen if you run the playbook. Okay, so same command up arrow, remove that list tasks. Hyphen hyphen check. Yeah, enter. So it will show you exactly what will happen. It's kind of a preview. Maybe before printing we can do preview printing, right? The same concept. It won't do exactly what you want to do. It won't do. Just it will show you if you run your playbook how it runs. Maybe it will execute or not. That's what it will show. It's not actual run. Maybe you can test it. Can you open your playbook once? VA playbook. VA with VA.
Oh, VA. Yeah. Okay.
Let's add one more task and run the dry run so that you can verify them. Go to the last step.
Last step, GG.
Capital G. Capital G will take you to the last line.
Okay.
So hyphen name. Hyphen space names colon. What we'll do? Let's run some command. Okay. Let's start the service. You are installing HTTP in the about task, right? Yeah.
Yes.
So starting the service. starting the service. So the module name is service. Name equals to service name, state equals to started. Service name, HTTPD.
Okay.
Service you want to start. HTTPD I already installed in the about us. So I'm starting, just I'm showing. State equals to started. Started. First go to your client. I think yesterday we started it. Go to your client and check it. Check the status, system CTL. Status. Are you sure this is the client one? I mean the QA machine.
Client one. Client okay. QA machine, yeah.
System CTL, status, HTTPD. Yeah. Okay, it's in inactive. Go back to master. And so actually this playbook, what it has to do? Again, it has to start my service, right? Save it.
Yes.
But if you run in dry run mode, it won't start. It will just show you what will happen exactly. Yes. Run your playbook without hyphen check. Ansible hyphen playbook, playbook name. Oh, sorry. Hyphen hyphen check we have to do, right? That is our concern. I'm sorry. Oh. I thought of asking in hyphen hyphen check mode. Actually, both will show you the same output. But the thing is, hyphen hyphen. Okay, let's make it stop. Now go to your client. What is the status? Check it now. Is it in running state now?
Yes.
It's running state. Go open your playbook and just change it as stopped.
Okay.
Now we'll use hyphen hyphen check mode.
That's capital G and I.
Instead of started, make it stopped. Spelling wrong. Double P A.
Okay. Okay, right now. Save W Q
W. Now run in double check mode, dry run mode.
I mean Ansible.
Yeah, same command only hyphen with hyphen hyphen check.
Oh, with hyphen hyphen check.
Yes. See. Hyphen hyphen check also will show you the same stuff, but it won't happen actually. Go to client and check the status, still it will be running. Actually, my task, what it should do, it should stop it.
It should stop, right? Actually.
But
yeah,
see,
but it didn't.
Still, it's my application is running because I run in dry run mode, not actual run. Dry run, it will show just a preview how it will run exactly. Okay, that is what dry run. Now, without running my playbook, I can check the syntax also. Go back to putty, master, up arrow, hyphen hyphen syntax hyphen check.
Hyphen hyphen syntax.
Hyphen syntax, spelling wrong. AX.
SYNTEX, right?
AX. Syntax or syntax? I think syntax. AX, not EX.
Yeah. Okay.
Hyphen check.
Check.
Enter. So if everything correct, it will show like this. Can you open your playbook and let's delete one space?
Playbook, okay.
So as I told you in your playbook, guys, spaces are very, very important. One less space. Can you remove space? For tasks
from here,
reduce one space.
Reduce, okay.
Yes.
Insert. Okay.
See, escape. Actually, it should be under host, right? Now see.
Yes.
But it will show you. Don't worry, guys. YAML language is very, very friendly language, it will show you exactly where could be the issue. Nearby, it will show you. Yeah, press enter. See, it's clearly showing you.
Yeah.
Where is the issue? Mm-hmm. You can easily find out. Maybe you can try later, remove spaces somewhere in between the tasks also. It will clearly shows you in which line could be the issue. Okay. So this is what -- check, -syntax check, then list of tasks. Now I want to run. So maybe just assume that I have 20 tasks in my playbook. Okay, 20 tasks I have in my playbook. Now change that, just resolve that issue. Whatever okay. You change, right? Again, get back, save it. And the syntax check. See, if everything correct, it will show like this. Just assume that I have a 20 task or 30 task in my playbook. I want to run from third or fourth task. I don't want to run first two tasks for some reason. Okay, let's see how to do that. Upper again. Remove that -- syntax. -- start. -at.
At. At. A-T-E.
Yes. No, at. Just at.
At.
E. -tasks. Task. Equals to. It's just a task.
Okay.
Equals to double quote start, open and close. Within that, write your task name. Exact name you should have. Task name. From which task you want to start?
Start is,
your
this
task
one,
name, the description.
Oh, description.
Yeah, description of your task. Exactly, it should be there. Already we have seen the list, right? Maybe
yes.
From there you can pick it up. From which task you want to start?
Let's say
pick one up. Just scroll up. You can see from above, right? So here you have four tasks. Maybe take it from installing a package.
Installing package, yeah.
Anything you can take any, you can pick it anything. As it is, it should be, including spaces.
Let me check. Installing a package.
Yes.
Yeah, that should be okay.
Press enter.
Okay, yeah, it starts from installing
package. Started from installing package only.
Mm-hmm.
Not from first to ignore.
Mm-hmm.
Not only first to, it's up to you. Based on your requirement, I may have n number of tasks in my playbook. I don't want to run first 10. I don't want to run first 20. I want to run from 21. So that task name you have to give. So from there only your task will be run. Now, I want to be in interactive mode. For each and every task, it should ask me yes or no. Okay, same up arrow, -- step. Instead of that -- started task, -- step. Remove everything.
Okay.
-- step. What -- step will do mean? It will ask you yes or no for each and every task. Yeah, enter.
Yeah.
Interactive mode, -- step. Press Y.
Press Y.
Anyway, it should run on QA.
Okay.
Press Y again.
If we say no, then?
No. No means it won't trigger. This task won't be triggered.
Okay, yeah.
Again, wait. So you have one more option also. Yes, no, no, yes means it will trigger that particular task. No means it won't trigger that particular task. Then what is continue? Continue means now onwards it won't ask yes or no. Just press C.
Press C.
It won't ask yes or no now. For any task from now onwards.
Oh, yeah. It will go continue.
Ahead. Yes. Mm-hmm. That is what the difference. Yes means the particular task will be triggered. No means that particular task will be ignored. Continue means now onwards it won't ask yes or no. Maybe just assume that you have 20 tasks in a playbook. First 10 tasks I want to be in an interactive mode. Yes or no it should ask. Whatever the task I want to start, I will start. Remaining I will say no. From 10th onwards it should not ask yes or no for me. Simply I will press C. Take care. C means continue. Okay. Now let's jump on to your playbook. Guys, these all are shortcuts. If at all you required, you can go with that instead of your whole playbook. Now open your playbook.
Okay.
Amar, can we set to end to task also? Means if we have 30 tasks, we want to run 10 to 20. Is it possible?
In that case, I don't think so. Maybe start and end. I'm not sure I ever tried. But if I want to run 10 to 20, I can do one thing. So I can go with interactive session. So maybe first 10, I will say no. Then after 10 to 20, I will say yes.
Yes,
then up no continue. Continue means even for 20 to 30 also will be triggered, right?
Okay. Yes.
From 20 to 30 I will say no again. Like that I may. So it is one option. I think end task also option is there. Let me just go to Google once. Dharmanshu.
Yes.
Just Google it. How to run from one task to another task in Ansible. Maybe how to run right in this way. How to run task between some task. Okay, just a minute. Let me check from my end. No, I think that option is not available. Maybe we have to again deep dig to get that option. By default option not there. Even I have to check that. Okay, that's fine. Maybe so Just you guys also try for that option. Google, no option. So like this, whenever we got such kind of task, such kind of request, we have to be again Google. Okay. So even right now, I'm not sure.
Okay.
Now let's talk about tags. So what is tag means? Okay, Nathan, just a minute. Just assume that you have again 30-40 tasks in your playbook. Okay, again 30-40 tasks in your playbook. So in that case, and in that playbook, some of the tasks are related. Some are user related, some are group related, some are some application related, some are some database related. Okay. So what I can do, that means all related stuff I can tag with one name. Maybe all user related, I'll make it as one user related, user tag. It's up to you. So maybe let's do one thing. For 3 and 4, make one tag. Go to the third test task.
I mean,
third task, installing a package.
Okay, installing a package, yeah.
Yeah, last line after that git.
Okay.
Last line. So equal to with item with underscore items. Above line. In the same task,
okay.
Yeah, equals to with underscore items. I mean, in the same position, in the same position. No, in the same position of with underscore items.
Oh, with underscore, yeah. Got it.
Yes. So tags.
Tag. Okay.
Name is different. Name is tags.
Tag. Okay. Tags.
Tags. Colon. Your tag name, maybe httpd, space, always after colon, space, yes. Give the same tag to fourth one also. Just assume that third and fourth are related. So I can tag it. Yeah, go to fourth step. In the fourth step also.
Right here.
Fourth one, fourth task.
Fourth task last is, task. Oh, last task, sorry.
Same again, tags colon httpd.
Okay.
Maybe for the second task, give as a user for the second task.
Okay.
One more tag. Yeah.
Okay.
Tags. Like this in my file, I'll give tags to all my. It's up to you. For some of the tasks you can give, for some tasks wherever it's not required, you no need to give. But all related tasks I can give one name. So one more tag I given now. Now save it. Maybe
users?
This is also one of the option, Mallika. You asked, right, from 20 to 30, how can I run? Maybe you can give tags to the 10 to 20 tasks, same tag. Maybe
so
this is one of the option. Yeah, save it.
User or users?
That's fine. You like
that's fine.
The tag name, it's up to you. Wherever you need, you want to give the same tag, you have to give same tag. Yeah, save it. Now run that --- list tasks. Same that --- list --tasks --tags both are same. --- list.
Okay, steps, no, right?
--list. --tasks.
--tasks.
It will show tasks and tags also. Tasks.
Oh, sorry, tasks.
Okay, that's fine. Task also it has taken, no issue.
Okay, yeah.
See, it's showing the tags also. Even you can see only tags also. --tags. I mean, list --tags. Up arrow.
Okay.
Tags.
Tags.
It will show only tags. How many tags you have? Okay, now I want to run only HTTPD. It doesn't matter. It's not, it may not be continuous tasks. Maybe third task, seventh task, 20th task. These all are, I made it with single tag. Just assume that. So only those tasks will be triggered. Go ahead and trigger now. Up arrow.
Up arrow.
Hyphen hyphen tags.
Hyphen hyphen.
Yeah, hyphen hyphen tags. Space your tag name. Which tag? Maybe just press user.
Okay.
Only user tag will be triggered now.
Okay.
Kind of shortcut again.
Okay.
No other task will be triggered. Now give only HTTPD. Only HTTPD. Wherever you give an HTTPD tag, that task only will be triggered. I think we can go with this option for 10 to 20. So all tasks I will give with one tag. So if I run with this, the tags, it will run only that particular 10 tasks. See? So I have HTTP tag for two tasks. So both the tasks has been triggered. Okay. Maybe I can do, I can give multiple also with comma. Multiple tags also with comma. Up arrow. Comma user.
Okay.
Both will be triggered. Okay. So one more scenario is there. Just assume that I have multiple tags in my playbook. Maybe 100 tasks I have. Out of it, 10 tags I have. Okay. I can say one thing. Instead of running particular tasks, I can ignore particular tasks so that except that tag, remaining all will be triggered. Up arrow. Instead of hyphen hyphen tags, use hyphen skip hyphen tags. Hyphen skip hyphen tags. Remove that HTTPD. Give one of the tasks, your wish. You want to skip user task. Enter. Except the user tag, everything will even. Okay. So just a minute.
Hyphen hyphen skip. Is it not hyphen hyphen skip?
I'm sorry.
He gave only one hyphen before skip.
Okay, maybe just yeah. Go with hyphen hyphen skip. Enter.
Okay.
Yeah. So it will skip only that user tag. Remaining all the tasks, even the task which doesn't have tag also will be triggered. Again, shortcut. Maybe instead of specifying all the tasks, all the tags, I can do in reverse way. I can ignore one of the tags. So remaining all the tasks will be triggered. That is also you have an option. See how simple Ansible. It's like general English. You no need to write any code. But the same task, if you want to go with a shell script or Python, you should have write a big like a hundreds of lines to go with this much. I mean this many tasks. The same task you have to write for if you want to go with shell script or Python. You should write a big code with some conditions, with some for loops, if conditions, lots of things you have to do. But here, see how simple it is. You no need to write any code. Already predefined modules we are using. Predefined module means it's all the modules developed in Python language, guys. Ansible is developed on Python language. The modules also developed on Python language.
So I have a question here, Amar.
Yes.
So you are telling using Ansible, we no need to write any for loop or something, right?
Yes.
Okay. So I have a scenario like this. Previously, if you remember 2-3 weeks ago, I was asking you one question, how to do incremental deployments, right? So at that time, after suppose I have a source folder which has some 100 class files and 200 some tables or something which supposed to be deployed. So my next commit in next sprint is going to get me around another 10 classes addition. Now I want to deploy only the 10 classes, not already deployed 200 or 100 classes previously what was done earlier. So for that one, you ask me to do one code to make it like a for loop and try to capture those class files from the commit using a tag between git def between head and the previous commit wherever I need those changes from, right? So if I need to do that one using Ansible, first I will write a git diff command as one task, as first task,
okay.
Try to find out the difference. And now
just a minute, in that case maybe everything is not possible with Ansible. Also in Ansible all the modules may not support your scenarios. Maybe sometimes I have to use again my shell script include inside my Ansible. So what I will do first, I'll do my shell script.
You will call shell file inside Ansible.
Yes, you're right. Maybe Ansible is still in developing mode. Okay, still they are developing.
Okay.
Not
because I don't know how to write that for loop in using shell. I don't know how shell language. So I thought I can use Ansible using simple English. So
no, maybe all the scenarios may not possible in Ansible. Again, in such a case, you have to write for shell script. I'm not saying that everything you can do with Ansible. Whatever you do with shell, you cannot do with Ansible. Sometimes what you will do, we'll write one shell script first. That script you will call it from Ansible.
Okay.
Maybe I'm saying whatever you can do with Ansible, but those are very easy when compared to shell script. That's what my intention. But I'm not saying that everything, whatever you do with shell script, you cannot do with Ansible. Sometimes again, you have to go with shell script also.
Okay.
Based on my scenario. Maybe I think whatever the scenario you said, it might be possible, but the exact modules and all, we may have to find out. Or else, still some modules may not be maybe already available for us. Okay. So again, you have to be again dig the stuff. What module you have to use for your exact requirement, and it might be possible. It may not be possible. Okay. So it's completely DevOps itself like that. Everywhere you will get different requirements. Okay, here based on your company requirement, your application team's requirement, you have to find out what I can do. Which tool I have to use? Should I go with Ansible or should I go with shell script?
Okay.
Wherever it is possible, you have to write. Okay. So always I'll go with the easiest one only. Right. So I'm saying Ansible is the easiest one when compared to shell script. If possible, I'll write Ansible. Otherwise, I should have go with the shell script itself, even though it is not easy, right?
Okay.
Yeah. Okay then. Now, so this is about
just one more question to all the students here. Does anyone have a shell scripting experience here? Dharmanshu, Sri Mai, anyone?
No.
Okay.
Yes.
No problem. Thank you.
Okay, then.
Go ahead.
Yeah. So where are we? We are at task tags button, right? Okay. Yeah, open your playbook. Go to the last tag, last task. One more task, hyphen name, type a name colon running Linux command. So which module I have to use to run a Linux command, to run a shell script? So which command I have to use, which module I have to use? Command itself.
Okay.
Sometimes module may not be available, okay, for your requirement. So Vishwa, as I told you, the command may not be available, the module may not be available in your Ansible. So simply go with command module and run your Linux command. Yeah, command colon uname space hyphen a, the Linux command you can run, space hyphen a. Yeah, here guys, uname hyphen a command should show my system, whatever the group, which group you are running on, QA group, right? So it will show, it should show the kernel version. Actually, if you run this command in command line, it will show directly, but here it won't show you. So can you run this command?
Okay.
So actually in playbook, the output won't be displayed directly. Save it. Run your playbook. Normally, Ansible iPhone playbook, just playbook name.
Okay.
Yeah, good. Playbook name. So actually, as part of my playbook, it should display. I'm asking to run that uname hyphen here, but it won't display. Is it displaying any output here? Not at all.
No.
It's not display. See, simply it's saying running Linux command. Where is my output? It's showing whether that output triggered or not. It. What is my intention? My intention is to get that output, right? So actually what you have to do here, you have to register that output, then only you can see that output. Open your playbook. So let me ping you something.
VA or CAT?
VA. I'm pinging you in WhatsApp.
Group, no WhatsApp, okay.
I just pinged you.
Group or person?
Group.
Yeah, I don't see anything yet. Okay, yeah. So you want me to copy and paste here somewhere?
Yeah, type it in your playbook.
Okay, where last?
Yes.
Okay.
Which output you want to register that okay. place?
Yeah.
Yes. Register colon and your wish. The name can be your wish.
Okay.
Space, register space, your wish. Yes. Next okay. line. Hyphen debug. Yeah, hyphen debug. Colon.
Space,
MSG.
Right? Hyphen debug together.
Yeah, hyphen space. Yes, hyphen debug. Hyphen debug. Colon message MSG equals to Double quotes. Amar, the variable name, capital A. You given capital A above.
Okay.
The same name you should give. It's up to you. Whatever
yes.
the in register field, whatever the name you given, the same name you have to give here. Yeah. So you have to register the output. Then only that output will be visible. Yeah, save it now.
STD OUT, right?
Yeah, STD out.
Oh yes, STD OUT. ST.
Yeah. Means standard D. output.
OUT.
STD OUT means standard output.
Standard output, okay.
You can see error, standard error. Save it. Run your playbook now. Something wrong.
Register Amar.
Okay.
Debug. Here.
Go
here.
To your playbook again.
Yeah.
That hyphen debug should be with hyphen name, with the position of hyphen name.
Okay.
Hyphen debug should be. Yes.
Okay.
Save it now.
Okay.
The separate task it is. Yeah, see, now it is showing below one, below.
Here?
Yes. See the output?
Kernel version.
That is what we need, right? So as I told you, the output directly you can, but if you run command, it will show you directly. Can you run Ansible hyphen m command hyphen m command hyphen a double quotes uname hyphen a and group uname hyphen a? That is to see kernel version. What is my kernel version? Space QA. You have to give the group name, right?
Okay.
See? Here it is showing, but in playbook it won't show directly. You have to register the output if you want to see any output. Then only it will show the output. Any output you can register. Even that installing output also, is it showing to you? No, right? There also you can see the output if you register a variable. Okay, so by default it won't show any outputs in a playbook. If you want to see playbook, you have to register a variable, and that is the first one. And one more thing, when condition. Now open your playbook.
Okay,
open your playbook. So let me give you one condition. So when condition, so it's kind of if condition in shell script. Already some predefined variables will be available in. Already some predefined variable available in Ansible. So just assume that your QA group has lots of servers. Maybe Ubuntu there, Red Hat you have, CentOS you have, okay, Windows you have. And obviously if you run Red Hat command and CentOS, sorry, Red Hat command and Ubuntu, does it work? If you run Red Hat command and Windows, does it work? Obviously
no,
no, right?
No,
the task
no.
will be failed. So instead of failing a task, you can do one thing. You can give when condition for that particular task. I give it, just I pinged you one
yes, yeah,
so just keep it somewhere for any task your wish.
I'll just put it on the last one. Okay,
it should be under the task.
Oh, under the task. So let's say here, so After tags, it's okay.
Before the tags.
Before tag, okay. Okay.
Yes. So see here, what I am saying exactly, run this task only when condition is passed.
Okay.
Already some predefined module, predefined stuff you will be there. Simply what I am saying, Ansible OS family equals to Red Hat, CentOS, Ubuntu. So I'm saying right. That if it is a Red Hat family, then only run this. So which OS yours?
CentOS.
Okay, do one thing, because CentOS is a Red Hat family only. Make okay. It Ubuntu.
Ubuntu. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, save it now. So what I am saying, especially for that particular task, I want to run it only on Ubuntu servers. I don't know how many Ubuntu, how many Red Hat, how many, like just assume that I have multiple types of distribution in my QA group. That especially that particular task, I want to run only on Ubuntu machines. I don't want to run on CentOS Red Hat, because obviously the command will fail, right?
Yes.
So run this playbook.
Okay. Right?
Yeah. No, not this command.
Oh,
playbook.
Oh, sure. Oh, yes. Okay. Yeah.
See, it's skipped because my QA group is simply CentOS. It's not CentOS. Ubuntu. Right. If it is, so it won't run any machine, only so it will go to each and every QA server. It will run. If it is only CentOS, it will run. Otherwise, it will skip.
Okay.
If you have 100 servers in QA group, in for all 100 servers, it will go and it will check whether that OS family is Red Hat or Ubuntu, whatever the when condition. First, when condition will be visible. If when condition pass, then only the task, that particular task will be triggered. Otherwise, no. Okay. So this is what when condition. What is the time now, guys?
11:25.
Okay,
I mean,
so,
yours is like almost 9. Sorry.
Yes, 9 o'clock.
Yeah.
Okay, then it's enough for today. And tomorrow, we are going to start a new topic called roles, Ansible roles.
Okay.
Okay? Yeah, so again, roles is also similar to playbooks. It is also set of playbook roles, but very important. Definitely, it is a little difficult topic because it has many directories. Okay, so we'll discuss about roles in tomorrow class. So it's okay. So it's a set of playbooks, set of directories, kind of functions. We'll discuss more about that roles in tomorrow class. Okay, it's enough for today.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, okay then, guys. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah, bye.